Namaste, myself Ganesh, Faculty of Social Studies. Today we'll learn 10th class lesson. The name of the lesson is Ideas of Development. As we know that ideas of development means what? The development means the process of development is called as development. The process of development is known as what? Development. See, everybody have their own aspirations are there regarding development. Okay, in this context we have seen number of examples in first video. See, like a landless labor, this is what second video. Okay, now previously things what we have learned, some landless labor, their development according to his view. What is development? See, a landless labor is development means he has to get that employment, regular employment. That is his development. In his view, what is development? If he gets that regular employment, that is his development. Suppose a rich farmer is there. What, according to his view, what is his development? If he gets appropriate prices for his crops, then according to his view, that is development. Okay, these are the, like, you know, one more example we discussed in previous videos. What is that? A urban girl, according to her view, what is development? If he gets all type of liberties, including along with her brother, that is development. According to her view, that is development. If she gets education, equal respect, equal opportunities, okay, if she gets all these things, that is a development. According to her view, that is her development. Now, dimensions of the development. In this context, we learn about the dimensions of the lesson. Dimensions of the development. See, development contain of so many, dimensions are there. Among, first one is economic dimension. Development means what? Generally, people will think that if we earning good amount, then automatically people can tell that yes, they are developed. How the people is assessing that one? Because of if we go, what suppose we are going to assess X person development, how can we assess that X person whether that person is developed or not? See, we see first we observe his way of living style, the cost of living. Okay, cost of living, how much cost? See, cost of living, we see cost of living. In what ways you can say that cost of living? Which vehicles they are using, which food they are receiving, okay, which type of circumstances are there, which type of environmental is there. See, whether he is living in a slum area or poor area, so how he is receiving, how he is living. See, we can, if we see and we can assess that one, okay, that is called as what? Cost of living. So that is generally we say that is what? Yeah, economic condition. And next one, what is that? Yeah, development dimension. Second one is what, Nana? Second one is social equality. As you know that India is contain of, see, what is that? Ladder type of caste system is there. Casteism is there in India. Okay, see, most of the lands are within the hands of some section people are there. Okay, some sections are there. So when these lands are going to be distributed, automatically these poor caste people also, they can be treated equally. So what is that? Ultimately what we have to give, some we have to make some push in economic criteria. So when the economic equality is taking place, ultimately social equality also will take place, and that leads to remove the discrimination. That one also you understand here. Next one, equality. See, so is equality, gender equality, gender discrimination. See, I told you before, just what I said here. Suppose a woman who is receiving education in a girl who is receiving in a village, and the same age girl who is receiving in urban areas. See how much variation is there, just you observe that one. In rural areas, they may or may not send to private school, but here in urban areas, even though she is girl, but they are sending to even, you know, corporate schools to receive education. That you have to understand. What you have to understand here, see that the inequality is there. There, what is that inequality is there among gender, on the gender basis. Next, security. What is meant by security? See, security, some sections they don't have security even. See, why? Because of lack of nutritious food. So lack of nutritious food is there. So when we give, because of when we give this type of nutritious food, like in Telangana region, Anganwadi centers are there. They are providing for nutritious food for them. That you understand. So security dimension also is one of the cause for development. Next, liberty. Human is a social animal. Human is he has the right to express his liberty. So rights are there. Liberty is there. So everybody, development means not only earning money, but he must get his liberty. That is also one of the diamond. If we get all these things, we can say that is development. See, development means not only earning the materialistic thing, but earning the non-materialistic thing. See, it's liberty. Can we show that is it a materialistic thing? But it is a non-materialistic thing. So here economy is a having of two-wheeler or four-wheeler. That is a materialistic thing. But here liberty we cannot see, but you experience that one. That is what non-materialistic things you understand. Next, public facilities. See, even though some areas, parks are there, good environments are there, parks are there. So they are providing some, mineral water, everything they are providing by the local government or state government or country. The rulers who are developed countries, they are providing each and everything they are providing. So when we get this type of facilities by the government, ultimately we can say that that is a developed country. So public facilities, arranging of public parks, planting the trees, they are giving good oxygen, they are making some, they are maintaining such a nice hygienic weather. Is it not public facilities? Yeah, public facilities means they are giving some, like library facilities, internet facilities to enhance good education. So these are all undercoming by public facilities. So these are the major aspects of dimensions of development. Now come to here, next one is some development is measured by some two organizations. What are they? We see now. First one is the World Bank. Now we will focus on World Bank. World Bank and as well as UNDP. World Bank means what? See, World Bank was established by in the year of 1944. Okay, the headquarters of World Bank is at where? America, Washington. That you remember. Now, what is meant by UNDP? UNDP means United Nations Development Program. United Nations Development Program. Now, focus here. What they did here? If a country, these two organizations, they are preparing the countries, whether they are developed or undeveloped or developing. Three stages they prepared that like that. Now we are going to know their measurements, on which basis they decided that whether a country is developed or undeveloped. Now let us focus here. See, if a country, according to World Bank, if a country is earning. If a country per capita income is, if a country's per capita income is, see here, see dollar 12,055 above. If a country's, you know, see if a country's per capita income is earning dollar 12,055 above, then we can say that country is a developed country. That country is a developed country. Suppose according to this here, if a country is earning dollar 955 to 12,055, we say that is a middle income country. That is called as a middle income country. Now next is here, if a country is earning dollar less than 955, we say that is undeveloped country. Imagine, see, World Bank is took the measurement, they compared with dollars. The World Bank is took the measurement. What is that measurement? Dollars. They compared the countries with American dollars. Okay, that is the thing you remember. Now next, UNDP, United Nations Development Program. This is UNO organization. You remember, United Nations organization, it is preparing. See, UNO is prepared this program, measurements for a country, whether developed or undeveloped or developing. Now focus, three things are there. What are they? Literacy rate. They take measurement. What is that? Literacy rate. Next, life expenditure, the life span, the span of life. Next, per capita income. They take these three things and they measure whether a country developed or developing or undeveloped. So these are the things in this video we learn. So the last video will be there for comparison of other states and countries also is there. That is, we see next video, that is part 3 regarding ideas of development. Thank you.